Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus. And in this one, we are going to the Gunbutt Graveyard. I'm gonna go see what happens to all the planes. Ooh. Coins here. Again, we're going for all the bottles. And this is essentially his ship graveyard, where all of the wrecked ships and planes, courtesy of the storm. I'll be back for those. Are essentially pulled in here to be gutted. Ransacked of all its essentially useful parts, and that is a glowing eye with tentacles. I'll probably be seeing that again. No, wait, hold on. Yeah, I'll be back in there in a second. Okay. Now, what I'm gonna do is this. There we go. I have to go back and get those anyway. Tracking section. And as you can see, it's 20 this time around, so not as much. But you get to see the floating eye, the glowing eyeball with tentacles. Again. It's looking at you. Hello, Mr. Parker Store. All the coins are respawned, but I don't need them at all. Well, apparently I'm having issues with jumping. Still. Alrighty then, let's try this again. Nope, that didn't work. You have to get killed like a couple of different times, they give you a horseshoe. Yep. It's like, okay, you're clearly having some troubles. Of course, I do it right that time. Got a flashlight guard. Just dropped it. This one is. And I believe they can hear the bottles break, so be careful. Okay, I got that one before you even get it. Well, you still whistled. There's nothing here, right? Just something to escape on. Bet forward! What the? You again? Alright. Go away. Rat! Oh, hey. Why are the rats carrying money? Whatever. There. Did I? Don't think I have to worry about this popper. But, twin barrels. Because they can really hold that much weight. Time you got me. I am having a horrible terrible time with these enemies right now. And there's our vault. Relatively short level.
This one was cake. Input 719.
719. Dang.
Oh, you lucky Sly! This page features Karen Kuprakiwa's coin magnet technique. All she had to do was stand near money, and it would magically jump into her purse. From now on, you'll automatically collect any coins you come near.
Alright. But this is the first show of a passive technique. All you have to do is essentially collect it, and you can automatically do it without having to push any buttons. As Bentley explained, it was a... you have to do a stand near the coins and they'll just fly toward you. That'd be pretty cool if it wasn't for the fact that coins are metal, and realistically that probably hurt quite a bit. I have to face it. Starfish guy. Put the invisible wall. Alrighty then. Excuse me, Mr. Starfish. Can you destroy this one too? Thank you. Yes, I know it's a walrus destroying you throwing the starfish. I'm still calling you Mr. Starfish. I don't want to go in. Let's do it.
We're in a submarine.
Yay! Not gonna be too happy with what I have to do here.
You found it, Sly! This is where Raleigh's gang of crabs stashes his sunken treasure.
Use
your sub
crabs
to blast them. The left analog stick controls the sub. Give it a try. Great! Use the right analog stick to fire its gun. That's it. Remember, you can always drive the sub in one direction while firing in another. To earn a treasure key, you'll need to collect all 40 chests. Do not let a crab take one into a tomb.
So essentially what I have to do is shoot the treasure chest to collect them. At the same time, make sure the crabs don't get me. So, we're gonna be playing a lot of the seagull game. Mine. Mine. Hard time with this. For the most part, it starts out easy, like everything, and then just difficulty amps up a lot, especially when the trigger just land close to where the crabs come out of. And of course it takes about 4 to 5 hits to get trigger test.
Better luck next time.
Yeah. And sometimes it's hard to notice when the crabs have one. Especially since I have the volume so low. It's just a rather annoying sound as you hit them. I guess an easiest tactic to really do is just kind of continuously go in a circle. Your shots can range quite a bit. So, it's a matter of just speed and making sure and keeping an eye on where everything is. Keeping it as close to the rock as possible. So you can kill crabs all day long, but it's not gonna do much if you can't collect the treasure chest. And sometimes the treasure chests themselves will block your shots. So that can be a bit of a hassle. And sometimes you do just have to focus solely on destroying crabs for a couple of seconds. And with that, we are done.
Congratulations, wow. You did it.
And they're all sad and kill them all just for kicks and giggles. I had a lot easier time doing that this time than in my practice run. Wow. I have another life. And that took a lot less time than I thought it would. I think I'll call it an episode anyway. So, well, my beloved audience, thank you very much for watching, and until next time, I bid you adieu.